It's been an improvement, Brian, and the best indicator of that is look right up there. That is a light that is on a street light that is actually working in Norborne. In fact, all around town, the lights are starting to go on. That's the good news, but they're not out of the woods. The police chief just a little while ago took me on a tour of the hardest hit areas, areas that will not heal in a day.
This one, wind took it out and just obliterated the old house. Here?
If anyone knows how hard it's been to live in Norborne the last 28 hours, it's Police Chief David Clemens.
I've always heard about it looks like a war zone. That's what it looks like, exactly what it looks like.
He rode out the storm in his police car.
But it was the worst wind I've ever sat in a car, or I've ever seen, period. It was really something.
Did you think for a second maybe I oughtn't be doing this?
Didn't have a choice. It's my job.
And this is his house.
Now, this
and
is your place here?
Yes, sir, it is.
My goodness, you didn't miss it, did you?
No, it didn't miss me at all.
Right next door, his 80-year-old neighbor has a 100-year-old tree decorating the upstairs. The home totaled.
The structure-wise, there's no way that they can get in.
There was a lot of progress made today. An unstable old building rocked to its facade came down. Trees were trimmed and hauled away. Power restored to most.
That's a main line going through, so they're probably trying to get their restoring service to that house there.
But this isn't a one-day recovery. Maybe not even a one-week rebound either.
That tree's got to be 75 to 80, 90 years old probably. Like I say, you couldn't have bombed the place and had much more damage.
That is certainly the case, and thanks to the chief for the behind-the-scenes area. That area has been closed off all day long today because that part of town is still considered a disaster area, and it is still in a state of emergency. Look over my shoulder, and you can see that the building that was causing so many problems, that has been torn down. We'll tell you a little bit more about that, but we want to talk about the volunteer effort because the police chief is so proud of the fact that so many people who helped clean up today were volunteers who came here from far and wide. Take a look. Yeah, many of these folks that came in were from churches from as far away as Independence and Columbia. They all came here to Northwest Central Missouri offering to help out total strangers. They'd seen the coverage last night on our news and they wanted to help out. And all they came armed with was a good attitude and, yes, chainsaws.
This gentleman that lives here was looked like he had a big project, and so we offered our service, and here we are.
And there they were, and in fact, they have been here all day long. In fact, a tree crew from Kansas City just showed up a couple of minutes ago. They said, we're going to come back. We want to help out as well tomorrow, so they will be back on the ground here as the west end of town still very difficult. The other crews that you saw all over town today, the Kansas City Power and Light crews and the MGE crews that had to come in here, cap off the gas when it was somewhat of a danger, and also some of the light crews that were working all day long trying to restore power. As of this hour, the latest check, 34% of the town still without power, but they're hoping that that will change. The goal, Kansas City and Power Light hopes to have all people who could have power tonight restored by midnight tonight. Now, that is not going to include everyone because, after all, there are certain people that have so much damage to their structures, they are going to have to basically fix up their property before they can, in fact, get their power restored. KCP&L crews dealing with two other problems. A main transmission line into town is down. It was downed by trees. It took power lines with them. Some families rounding up generators until the utility crews can restore the service.
Well, there were trees hitting the house and hail hitting the windows. And oh, my. It was terrible.
Now, the Red Cross also had this open. This is the Goppert Community Center, and they had it open for most of the day today. They served some 150 breakfasts and another 200 lunches today, all in an oppressive heat. This was the place where people simply came to get out of the 93-degree temperature, 94-degree temperature that they were dealing with today as they were trying to do all that work. There was a lot of bottled water available as well. So Very much progress as we come back out here live tonight, Laura. Lots of progress made, but there is still so much more work to be done. We're going to take a closer look at that building that I referenced and you saw in the story, the 106-year-old building that came crashing down today. We'll take a closer look at the guy who ran the business next to that, Larry Naslund. I talked to him last night. We'll get an update from him later in this newscast. Back to you.